Welcome, audience. As we all know, cost is an important part of any mine's operations and management. To learn more about reducing cost in the mining industry, let's welcome Mr. Jonas Elbert, Senior Wear Specialist, SSAB, Swedish Steel. Welcome, Mr. Elbert.
Thank you very much. I will start with sharing my presentation here. Okay, just a short introduction to myself. I started as at SSAB 2016. So, no, 2006, sorry. So it has been 17 years. And the last 11 years, I have been working as a wear specialist within SSAB. And that is mainly about traveling around, supporting mining industry around the world. Performing wear testing and trying to support our customers within the mining industry to reduce cost and be more cost efficient, prolong service life and so on. I will start with just a few minutes about SSAB. SSAB is a global steel company with a leading position within high strength steel. We are focusing on wear-resistant steel and other high-strength steel. So that is our key business. If we look a little bit on SSAB, last year we had 129 billion Swedish crowns in revenue. We are a little bit more than 14,000 peoples in 50 countries. We have been making steel since 1878, so it is more than 100 years right now. The yearly production is 8.8 million tons, and we are divided in different divisions, special steels, and we are have one division that is focusing on the Europe market, and then we have an American division as well, and a rookie construction department that is mainly supporting the building industry. We are strong globally, but also we try to be very strong locally because we have a lot of local stocks. We have sales and technical support that is working locally within different countries. So we have local people in India, we have local people in China, Australia, and so on. So we are a global company, but we try to be a local with local languages and local support and with local stocks as well. So that is our key business. So we are present in more than 150 countries that we are covering within our organization. Production is concentrated in Sweden and in Finland, and we also have two mills in US, one in Iowa and one other in Alabama. And so that is where we have the production today. But as I said, when we have local stocks and we have partners all around the world that is supporting mining industry to get our plates to the end user, the mining sites. Just a few words about the fossil free. We have a strategy to be fossil free, and we have developed this process for many years, and we will introduce fossil free steel in a global way at 2026. So then we will launch our premium product with the fossil free production with no CO2 footprints. So we will take away the production that is causing CO2 and make it from fossil-free sponge iron and with fossil-free electricity instead. We have also taken another step to be totally the leading sustainability performance in very large way at 2030. So in reality, all our sites would be fossil-free around 2030. If we move into the wear-resistant material for the mining industry, what we have done is that a few years ago, we launched our new product, Hardox 500 Tough. And this is the next step after Hardox 450 as a general wear plate. Because many years, Hardox 450 has been used as the general wear plate that is working more or less in all position in the mine, for mining trucks, for chutes, liners, and buckets, and so on. But a few years ago, we took the next step and moved up to 500 Brinell level instead. So this is many years of research to develop this product. And it's available today from 3 millimeter up to 25.4 millimeter. If we look a little bit on the mechanical properties of this material and compare it to Hardox 450 and Hardox 500, first of all, if we look at hardness, the Hardox 450 that we have today is supplied as a nominal hardness of 450 Brinell, but we have a hardness interval of 425 to 475. And this is a good interval. I mean, this is the best on the market. But with this new product, the Hardox 500 Tough, we have a nominal hardness of 490, but we have a much tighter hardness interval. So we guarantee all the plates that we supply have a hardness interval between 475 up to 505. So that is plus minus 15 Brinell. And that is the tightest hardness interval for a wear plate on the market. And this is important because when we are talking about service life and predicting service life and so on, everything is around hardness. The harder the material is, the better it will perform when it comes to sliding wear. And if you have a very tight hardness interval, you can plan and schedule your maintenance interval in a much better way instead. Also, this is important when it comes to formability of a plate, because if you're going to bend the plate, the bending process is related to strength of the material, and strength of a material is related to hardness of a material. So this means that if you're going to form a plate, then you will have more equal properties of the plate from plate to plate when you're going to form the plate. So it will be much faster process in the workshop when it comes to forming, due to the properties of the material is much equal from plate to plate. When it comes to toughness is also important when it comes to mining industry to reduce cracking and breakdowns and so on. If you look at the typical toughness of a Hardox 450, we have around 50 joules at minus 40 degrees Celsius. And if we compare that to Hardox 500 Tough, we are more or less on the same level. So we have 45 joules at minus 40 degrees Celsius as a typical value. But what we also do on this product is that we guarantee a toughness. We guarantee that all our plates has at least 27 joules at minus 20 degrees Celsius. And that is unique for a wear plate. So there is more or less no one else that is guarantee a toughness of 27 joules at minus 20 degrees Celsius. So this is important when it comes to the mechanical properties for a mining end user. When it comes to workshop properties, we try to design this product to make it very easy for our partners and workshop around the world to produce liner plates or produce mining trucks or whatever it is. So when it comes to welding, Hardox 500 Tough can be welded with an ordinary consumable without preheating for 60 millimeter and thinner. If you are thicker than 16 millimeter, we have a preheating recommendations of 75 degrees Celsius, and that is not much. So if you have thicker than 60 millimeter, we recommend a preheating temperature of 75 degrees. When it comes to forming, that is important because when we designed this product, we wanted to have a product that was behaving the same way as the Hardox 450 in the workshop, but we have an extra feature of 50 Brinell more or less. So When it comes to forming properties, we have the exact same recommendations as a Hardox 450 when it comes to minimum radiuses. So you don't need to change anything in the drawings and productions and so on when you upgrade from 450 to 500 tough. You can use the same drawings. If it's worked for Hardox 450, it will work for Hardox 500 tough. And that is also very good because you don't need to do any new investments in the workshops to handle this material. Of course, the hardness is higher, and that means higher strengths. So you need a little bit higher forces in the bending machine. That is, I mean, a physical law, more or less. But in one way, I mean, if you have a wear plate that is lasting or that is more wear resistant, then you can actually reduce the thickness and keep the same service life. And by that, you will actually reduce the bending forces in the machines. So there are ways to come around this. If we take an example of the wear resistance of Hardox 500 tough compared to Hardox 400 and Hardox 450. So if we have an typical iron ore, magnetite by iron ore, then we will look at the increased service life of 85 to double the service life compared to Hardox 400. And this is quite easy to do calculations on because we have created a software tool called WearCalc, where you can add different abrasive materials. You can compose your own rock, mineral analysis of your own rock, or you can use a typical iron ore, magnetite-based or hematite-based or coal or whatever you want to do your own wear calculations in a very fast and easy way. And this is available for all our customers at ssab.com. If we compare the calculation for iron ore from Hardox 450 to 500 tough, we are looking at 35 to 40% increased service life. So that is extremely good. And how can we utilize this increased service life in a smart way? Well, I have two examples that I want to show to you. One is, if we go back to the starting slide here, we have a mining truck. And this is very common in the mining industry. And they are having a high fuel consumption. They are having high wear rates. And I mean, they are costing a lot. So how can we utilize the Hardox 500 tough in a smart way here? If we look at the typical mining truck, they are running around 6,000 hours per year. So, and maybe a typical service life is 3 years. So that is 18,000 hours. Very common to have a floor plate thickness of Hardox 450 of 25 millimeter. That is quite common to have. If we look at moving up to Hardox 500 tough, in reality, you can actually use a 20 millimeter of Hardox 500 tough instead of the 25 millimeter of Hardox 450. And what will this mean for the end user, the mining guy? Well, they will save 2.3 tons by just reducing the thickness of 5 millimeter. They will have the same service life because you have reduced the thickness, but you have a much more wear resistant material instead. And the consequence or the benefit for the mine is that it will save a lot of fuels. So just for one mining truck, they will save 10,800 liters of diesel because the mining truck is running around with 2.3 tons less weight all the time. Even though it's fully loaded or it's empty, they will always have 2.3 tons less material. Of course, if you can increase the capacity of the mining truck, that will mean even more savings, but it is a little bit more difficult. But the fuel savings will always be there. And of course, you will have CO2 emissions by reducing the diesel with 1,670 tons of CO2 emissions per year. But also what is important here is that we have producers of this mining trays. And of course, if they utilize this Hardox 500 tough instead, they will of course order 20% less material because they have reduced from 25 millimeter to 20 millimeter, right? And also welding is a very big cost for producing these mining trucks. And by using a thinner material instead, they can increase the welding speed with 15%. And of course, they will reduce the welding consumable with 15% by just moving down to 20 millimeter instead of a 25 millimeter. And this is just an example of a mining truck. There might be other thicknesses, but the way is the same with upgrading to 500 tough. You don't need, if you don't want the longer service life, you can utilize the lighter weight to create a product with a lighter weight instead and save fuel and production costs. We have also evaluated the dent resistance because in mining truck and mining equipment, wear and tear is a big issue, and dents is something that will be caused by big rocks falling down in the bottom of the mining truck. And Hardox 500 Tough has higher strength than the Hardox 450. And by that, of course, you reduce the dent resist. You reduce the dents and the depth of the dents. So we have created our own machine to evaluate the dents. It's a drop hammer rig where we are dropping heavy weights up to 400 kilograms from almost 3 meters height on a plate sample to evaluate how much less dents do you have. And this is just an example in the graph here that the Hardox 500 Tough is have a much lower depth of dents. I have another case example here. This is just an example of a dump pocket for an apron feeder, where the mining trucks is unloading the ore that they are coming with into a dump pocket. And if we take an example of a mine that is mining 36 million tons per year, they are currently using mild steel. They have 2 to 3 maintenance stops per year, and they want to reduce the maintenance to 1 time per year instead. And the liner plates is 480 millimeter times 480 millimeters, and it's 4 holes in this liner plates, and it takes quite a huge number of liner plates in these dump pockets. So once again, we can use the wear calc and make a simple calculations. And for this iron ore example, we have an increased service life compared to mild steel of 450 is lasting 3.4 times longer, and Hardox 500 Tough is lasting 4.8 times longer. And that is not, this is what will happen if you upgrade from mild steel to Hardox 500 Tough. You will look at approximately almost 5 times longer service life. So how can we use these numbers? If you look a little bit on cost, this is not exact numbers or something like that. It should be looking more like a relative comparison, but it's more fun to have some numbers here. So if we look at plate price, maybe the mild steel is costing for this dump pocket 20,000 of some currency, and the Hardox 500 Tough will cost 50,000 instead. Cutting cost, we need to cut the liner plate, so that will have a cost for cutting the material. Drilling cost, we need to drill the holes, and of course it will be more costly to drill in Hardox 500 Tough compared to mild steel, so the cost will be higher for that one. Transportation cost, we need to transport the liner material, the liner plates to the mine, but it doesn't matter if it is a Hardox 500 Tough or if it is a mild steel that we are transporting to the mine. Attaching the liners, that will be a cost. We need to have a couple of guys that is installing the liner plates in the chutes for a few days or something like that. And in the end, we are looking at the total cost for this liner package that mild steel is costing 46,000. And if you compare it to Hardox 400, that will be 66,000 instead. And the Hardox 450, 69,000. And the Hardox 500 Tough will be a little bit more than 80,000 in cost. So at this point, we have almost the double of the cost for the Hardox 5 and a tough solution. And of course, this is, I mean, difficult to sell liner package of Hardox 5 and a tough if you look at these numbers. But if we utilize the increased service life instead and look at it in a different way. So we add a few rows here. The service life of MildSteel is one, and we can say that it lasts 100 days to make it easy in this example. And then it will be Hardox 400 will last 2.4 times longer, so that's 240 days. The Hardox 450 will last 3.4 times, and that means 340 days. And the Hardox 5 and a tough will last 4.8 times longer, and that means 480 days. So if we divide this cost with the number of days that it's lasting, then we will see that the MildSteel is actually costing 460 per day, but the Hardox 5 and a tough will only cost 168 per day. So that means that we have one third of the cost with utilizing Hardox 5 and a tough instead. So in the end, depending on what the purchaser of the mine and the mining guys are looking at, of course, buying the liner package will be more expensive, but in the end, they will earn a lot of money by upgrading to Hardox 5 and a tough instead. So this is, I think, how we should look at the cost for a package of liner plates. That we need to look at the total cost of ownership for a set of liners, or if it is a mining truck, how much can we save with diesel consumption and so on. So there is a possibility to reduce cost in the mine by upgrading to Hardox 5 and a tough instead of 450, or if it is mild steel or 400 Brunel steel or something like that. So that is how we should work within the mining industry. By that, that was my last slide, and I want to thank everyone that is listening to this. And if there is any questions, I don't know, but we have technical people in India and in other countries as well. So please contact them and go into our homepage and look at the products and reference cases with Hardox 5 and a tough from all parts of the world, the reference cases. So I don't know if there is any questions.
Yeah, so the question is, how good is Hardox while handling iron ore slurry compared to knee hard casting?
Knee hard is extremely hard, but it is a very expensive material, and it's also a very brittle material. So handling iron ore slurry, if there is not any problems with cracking issues for the knee hard, I guess that knee hard will have a little bit longer service life than Hardox 500 tough. But if you look at the cost for knee hard, maybe it is several times more expensive than Hardox. So in the end, a solution with Hardox 5 and a tough in some positions could be possible, but it's depending on the type of iron ore slurry and the type of equipment that is handling the iron ore slurry. So I think we need to look a little bit closer on the specific machine or equipment for right. handling this.
We have another question also. Are the Hardox plants are the Hardox plates re-welded with the Hardox layer once they are worn out, or are they replaced?
When the Hardox is worn out, then you replace it with another plate. It's not an overlay product that you can weld a new Hardox on top of it. So it's a wear-resistant plate that is hardened in our quenching lines in Sweden and in US, and it's through hardened, even though it's 50 or 75 or 100 millimeter thick, you will have a hardness profile that is flat. So it is 490 Brinell all the way through, or whatever hardness it is, depending on the grade, of course. But when the Hardox is worn out, you will replace it with a new plate. That is how it works.
Okay, I'm sorry, but we are running out of time. So thank you, Mr. Jonas Elbert, for the knowledgeable insight, and thank you for taking time out for the questions as well. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'll move ahead with our event. Stay tuned.